So a few days ago, I made a video about DistroKid, the sad truth about digital distribution, and a lot of people reacted to it and left comments, and I really do appreciate all the comments in that video, but one of the questions that kept on being asked was, how do you promote your music then? Well, let me explain it in this video. What is going on, guys? DJ F here. So I'm going to give you 5 tips on how to promote your music, and it will be very helpful to you guys. As soon as I explain it to you guys, it's going to make a lot of sense because these tactics have been used by major artists all the way to indie artists that are very successful, and you will understand it because I will break it down to you very easily. So my first tip originally was to make good music. But what is good music? That is subjective. People have different tastes based on the community that they are involved in. So certain people from a certain community may not like a certain type of music. And there might be people that you might think is clearly bad, but they're very good at promoting their music. And therefore, they have a success rate that is higher than yours. So the first original tip that I have to give you guys, and you're going to think it's dumb, do challenges. Now, doing challenges is a very, very strong tactic. And if you look at the most recent challenge with Chris Brown, Heat, that song is really big. It's on its way to being platinum, and people are enjoying it. And Chris Brown built that video for challenges. So he challenged all the dancers out there, and even your common people that don't know how to dance are involved with this challenge, and they are enjoying doing it. So it's involving a lot of people that might not even like Chris Brown or might not like his type of music, but they like that challenge, so they're doing that challenge. There's been several challenges in the past, of course, Nice for What or whatever the song was by Drake. Kiki, If You Love Me, you heard the song before. But that song was challenge-based. Like, they built that off of challenges. And that song blew up because of those challenges and many people doing that. And there are people out there that work on social media that understand that challenges are very, very important to getting your music out there. So therefore, they plan music around challenges. It makes sense, right? The next one, a lot of people might have problems with it, but I think it is a very, very strong tactic that is overlooked, and that is to do cover songs. Why should you do cover songs? Or at least cover hot topics at the very least. It's because a lot of people will research and look for that particular song when it is hot. And even if you cover a song that was very popular in the past, people might love you. You might build an older fan base that really might like you because you covered a song and did it very well. So if you re-sing a song that is very popular right now or in the past, that is a great way to build a huge audience, and people will respect you for it. I know that a lot of music producers watch this channel, and you understand that I do a lot of type beat tutorials or all that other stuff that is very good for SEO, and that's because it is a cover. It is a cover song. So with that, you'll understand why I'm building a huge base based off of that as well. So do cover songs or tutorials based on songs. Another one that is very overlooked, but is probably the most powerful one altogether, is influencers. Now, I know a lot of people look at me as I'm an influencer. I really hate being called that because I just enjoy making music altogether. But the reality of it is I have an influence on a certain group of people. So therefore, people reach out to me and ask me to cover their products and stuff like that. And if I really like it, then I show it to you guys. So with that being said, you can go to an influencer. It doesn't have to be directly in music, but if they like music or enjoy it, they might listen to it. And even if they say it's bad or if it's good, then you have reached another audience that you probably wouldn't have reached just by putting your music out on Spotify or any other streaming service, Tidal, Apple Music, or whatever. So going and hollering at an influencer is really good. And even if you have to pay for the influencer to check your stuff out, it might be well worth it. Another strong tip, but is overlooked, is collaboration. Now, this can go either way. Sometimes it can go really good. Sometimes it can go really bad. It can go left or right. But collaborating with somebody that is of a higher status than you is a good way to promote yourself as a musician, as an artist, as a music producer, or whatever you're doing. And collaborations just go a long way because you're introducing your audience to their audience. And it does help for you to kind of find somebody that is willing to collaborate with you that knows your value. So you don't necessarily have to go into it thinking, well, this person didn't want to collaborate with me, so screw them. Just be positive, move forward, and do whatever that it takes to get your music out there with another collaborator. Positive. But other than that, if the person that you want to collaborate with ask for money, yeah, if it's worth it, then go for it. I'm not totally for this tactic, but it definitely does work. I've seen a lot of smaller YouTubers go out and reach out to bigger YouTubers or superstars outside of the YouTube realm, and then they end up blowing up, and then their platform takes off, and people start listening to their music. So it is a really strong tactic that I really hate, but it really does work very well. Last but not least, a lot of people are probably going to think this is silly, but it's a really effective tool. And you will notice that a lot of people do base their release around memes. Memes of all things. So doing funny stuff and posting pictures of memes could very well promote your music the best way possible if done correctly. So I'm actually going to show you an example using my social media. So for a long time, I did not understand Instagram, so therefore explains why my Instagram is not popping like YouTube. So I had to make some adjustments, and the main way I made those adjustments was by using memes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a very unsuccessful video that I did that I put some quality time into, but it did not have the response that I wanted out of it. So this video right here is basically me just showing off music or whatnot. And I just thought to myself, well, a lot of people do that on IG and it has no value to it, even if it's good. And it had only 142 views. So I did this meme when you open too many plugins in your DAW, because I'm a music producer, and look at it. Only in 21 hours, I have 424 views. So a video that I did a few days ago has only 142 views, and it's not a meme. And I seen in this video, which is a shorter clip, that it got 424 views. So that is a huge response, and it can still grow from there forward. And not only that, more people will share it, and people will learn about me because I have stuff like my logo and my IG, and I have my SoundCloud, my Facebook, all that stuff where people can follow me. And I actually got a lot of people to follow me off of that alone. And let me go ahead and show you this meme right here, because look, everybody likes this cat meme right now. It's the thing. So what I did was I reposted something that I saw on Busy Work Beast page, which, hey, repost somebody else's stuff so you can share it with your community, because you never know the response that it gets. And if you see that it's getting a lot of response, then why not repost it on your IG page and see if people will respond to it? And it's FL Studio, Fruity Loops. And a lot of people chimed in, laughed. Some people left negative comments, but whatever. You got to look past that and understand that. So if I was to do that versus this picture right here, that got 46 likes, and I'm actually giving away a MIDI controller. Which one should I do more? I should do the memes more, right? Because more people are responding to it. Just makes sense, right? It all makes sense. And you'll see, once you start posting memes and mixing it up, that a lot of people are going to tune into what you do a lot more. And then they might start investing into your music and helping you grow. So that is a really helpful tip. It's probably the most effective tip that I can give you on this list. So tell me how you feel about these tips. Were they very helpful to you? Hopefully they were. And if you want more stuff like this, please leave a comment below. Let me know of other topics that you want me to cover, and I will do that. And I appreciate you for your time.